judge and coaches have taken the field.
The athletes of the field of play for the compound men semifinal match number two.
And here we go. So onto the field of play comes Stefan Hansen, the world number one,
who
took Federico Pagnoni out of the competition by 6 points in his quarterfinal match, and standing there looking confident.
Yeah, yeah, he's really the only guy that shot this whole thing so far, and just seemed like he was, you know, practicing. He just looked so easygoing and just relaxed.
Now, you wouldn't say relaxed was the word that you could use with El Mugatti, but actually his determination gives him that stillness, doesn't it?
Yeah, you can see the confidence in his walk. You know, he's definitely got it. I'm sure he's looking forward to this match.
Well, he's had the beating of Hansen this season. Beat him in the final stage in Berlin, and comfortably beat him too, actually. I think there was only 2 or 3 points in it in that match, but with two ends to go, he was just looked so solid. Hansen couldn't get near him.
Yeah, that's one that Stefan would like to definitely forget, and I'm sure he's thinking about that a little bit right now. See what kind of momentum they bring this match. Who's going to start out the strongest?
So Hansen back on target number one again, where he was this morning for the mixed team and where he was this afternoon for his first individual match. So he'll be happy with that draw.
Absolutely.
Yes.
That's a serious opening statement.
It
from
sure
El Mugatti.
Femden. Chi. Ni. Yep. Ni on a excellent shoot, Stefan.
You know that song, Anything You Can Do, I Can Do Better?
Yeah.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3.
9. There you go. 9 for El Mugatti.
Yeah, I wish I could say that song is for me, you know. I can't shoot like these guys.
Yeah, super. Excellent.
Do you see this standard improving year after year?
I do. And the shooters are actually getting younger. The ones who are winning are getting younger and younger. And it's just amazing. You know, the scores that are being shot are just...
Do you think younger archers now will go on to have long careers? Or do you think that it's your 20s now that are the years where you have to do the most damage?
I think there's something to be said. You can see the wind is shaking everything. There was a big gust that came through and he put it right in the middle. That was an outstanding shot, and that's why he's pretty happy about it. but I do think that is a good possibility. Just because, you know, these young guys are just hitting one after another. There's so many good, talented, young shooters. I've never seen that many of them as I do today. So it's fun to watch. And again, as an archer, I can admire the skill level that these guys
have. If you're not familiar with archery, it's the sort of sport that you can get into as a viewer, isn't it? Because the skill is evident, and watching it on TV, you can see the drama right up close too.
Yeah, that, you know, these head-to-head matches, and you can see it. It's, you know, if you're just standing there shooting a bunch of arrows, but you don't have a lot of room for error here. You know, not that many arrows.
Not at all.
Exactly.
One down on Hansen, a 9 fade.
That wind is still stronger than it was, but
that is super.
Someone doesn't care.
Not at all. So Georgia finds a 10 with that arrow.
He needed that one.
Femden.
Puts it on the line.
It should be a 9.
That's a 2. Den er langt inden.
Aferin. 9, 8, 7.
So with a slight let off, and he finds the 10, so he'll keep his 1 point lead, may even extend it to 2. You'll see if that 8's upgraded, and he probably will be.
Yeah, it should be. It looked pretty solid, actually. The fingers come through that line. But yeah, you can see it from there. That should be enough.
So what would your advice be then if you're thinking about taking an archery? You're watching this at home somewhere and you're impressed by what you see. What would you say to people who get to become a pro?
Please do it. You know, it's a great sport. Any age, any ability, it's great for, you know, anybody that has any type of disability too. You can shoot. It does not matter. It's a, you know, again, a sport where there's a huge family there of people that will help you. You just look for a dealer or a pro shop or somebody that can help you get started so you start the right way, and then just enjoy yourself. It's just a fantastic sport. It can take you all over the world. And if you get the bug like I did when I was young, it changes your life. Your life will evolve around it. It's just it's an amazing thing. Love the sport. Yeah, again, you look at somebody like Steve Anderson, he's really only been shooting about 5 years or so. You know, so he didn't start until after he graduated from college. So
it's not one of those sports like gymnastics or whatever that unless you start when you're about 6, you've got no hope. You can pick it up.
You can pick it up. And, you know, there's plenty of really, really good coaches out there to help you get started.
Another X for Hansen. 3 points now, and Elmer Gackley, not how it was in Berlin for him. He's trying to hang on here now.
Yeah, because Stefanos, he's looking calmer and calmer. Now that you can see the wind just affecting his bow there. And yeah, that was difficult for him. He was just hoping that he'd get a break and he'd calm down enough for him to settle and get a good shot off. But that one cost him. And then again, Stefan, he's up there. He gets on it, and it's gone before the wind really has a chance to move him around too much.
He was shooting much quicker than the Turkish archer in his first match, wasn't he? And that he was confident then, and now he's thinking about it a bit more, isn't he?
Yeah, right now you can see it in his face, in his body language. You saw how he walked out, and he was very confident, and just looked so really disappointed at this point, but he's still in it. He's still in it. He's definitely doesn't have much room to miss the 10 right now.
Yeah. So 30, 29, 30.
Yeah.
First three ends.
And you can see he's confident and smiling and having a good time. It's just, you can just see it in the body postures.
So words of encouragement from the Turkish coach for Emre Gökler, who will shoot first again on target number 2. And he's got a 5-point lead to try to eat into with his last 6 arrows of this match. He will have been confident coming to Rome because of his performances across the season, but it's slipping away from him here, and he needs to step up and find some tens pretty sharpish.
Yes.
Stephen.
Not good not, enough.
Yeah, it's not going to be what he needed there.
Hanson's going to have to give it some free time.
Yeah,
that doesn't look like it's going to happen.
No, I mean, when you look at the targets, look at his Stefan's last match and target, he just hammered the center. And he's doing it again here. He's just filling up the middle. And he's looking good.
He is, and it's a place in the final match against Gelatin that awaits for whoever wins this match. And
there's a reason why he's number one and world champion. So
finds the 10. The Turk, so 28 for him, 112. But Hanson really piling on the pressure now.
Still 6 points.
So 6 points the lead, and three arrows left for each archer. A smile on Hanson's face because he knows he's given himself a platform to turn this into a victory.
Yeah, barring something really crazy happening right now, he's looking good. He's in the driver's seat and really shouldn't be feeling all that much pressure. He should be feeling pretty confident, like, yep, I'm going to do a walk up here, I'm going to throw three more down in the middle, and move on. that's a great slow motion right there.
He's a top level international athlete, isn't he? But what I love about him is he's got a slightly sort of unkempt look about him. the odd face expression you see, it's like his mum was asking to tidy his room or something like that. You know, I don't mean any disrespect by that.
No.
But he's such a teenager, it's brilliant.
Yeah, you can see there, he's got his hat kind of sitting off on the side a little bit for sun and make sure he's got some shade in his eyes for aiming and things. So, he really needed that one in the middle.
He certainly did. And he's capable of it too. He just can't find it.
Yeah. Hope he finishes strong.
Nine from Hanson. The lead's still six.
Yeah, but he's like, yeah, whatever. You know, it's and when you've got that, it's. Again, there's not much pressure anymore. You're just disappointed because you want perfection.
Much better.
Yeah.
But later than he needed. So Hanson on for a 147 finish, which is what Gelatin shot in his match to win.
Put this one in the middle.
Yeah, strong finish now. Come on.
Nine.
So, anything on the target for Hanson?
Yeah, and that's good. You can just see it in his body, face.
Not just anything. An X10. Smash the center of the target.
This is a super relaxed shot. It was just like he was in practice.
So Stefan Hanson does what's required of him. He's the world champion. He's the world games champion. He's the world number one. And he's taken a giant leap towards becoming the World Cup champion of 2017 here as well. Stefan Hanson into the final against Gelatin, and it will be El Bagakli versus Anderson for the bronze, and that's our next match.
Should be a good one. We'll have to see. You know, I'm sure the Demir is really disappointed right there, and we'll see if he can come back mentally and get back focused and making good shots. I expect Steve, because Steve, he didn't shoot poor in his match against Brayton, but I expect him to come out here and be feeling pretty good. So it all comes down to the mindset.
So now that, with the benefit of having seen all those matches shot, when we looked at the brackets right at the beginning of the afternoon, the Gelatin Hanson face-off for the title was there for the taking, wasn't it? And that's what we ended up with.
Yeah, it really was. And there's two shooters that literally are so alike. They both are aggressive shooters. They're both, very accomplished. You know, Braden's a little bit more of a veteran, but this is going to be fun. They both feed off of emotion, and I'm expecting to see quite a bit of that in that match. But, you know, again, the first one here, you know, should be fun. Nobody wants to go home without a medal.
And we kind of saw that this morning with Sonicson, actually.
Yeah.
She had her eyes not unrealistically on the top spot here,
yep.
and she didn't quite make it, and then she came out for the bronze medal match, and she couldn't shrug that off. I mean,
right.